Welcome all of you to SST College of Arts and Commerce, Ullasnagar. This is SST Edupedia. Myself, Assistant Professor Sunetra Katekar. And today I am going to start the program which is IT, TYIT, Semester 6. And my course name is Information Technology Service Management. So, today I am going to cover service design, which is the important part in our service life cycle. This is the second part of service life cycle. So I covered this contents today: service design principles, design activities, service design models, service design process. So first, service design principles. Each and every life cycle has service life cycle has design, the second phase. So it is a very important part in our service life cycle. So there are some key principles of service design, so that we discuss about the key principles, which is the first: services must be designed based on customer's need rather than the internal needs of business. So according to customer's requirement, demands, we have to create the design of our service. So second one is, the input required for designing of services should always come from the users of the services. So input required in design service, that is the service, we have to give the service and according to users demand. Next is, the services must be designed and delivered in the participation of all relevant stakeholders. So these are the internal and external also. Number fourth principle is, services should be designed to develop a reliable and efficient system rather than component by component, which can lead to poor overall service performance. Again, next is, services should be designed based on creating value for users and customers and must be as efficient as possible. That means, if there is a value of creation is the major point in our service services, so that we have to mention or we have to create this design for particularly customers or for users efficiently, they will use this your services. So these are the basic key principles of service design. Now next part is design activities. So here there are seven design activities. First one is requirements of collection. So we have to ensure that all the business requirements, service providers requirements and technical requirements are clearly documented and approved. We have to collect the documents, but these are the totally legally or approved. So second one is business requirements. This is one of the activity which is the design of appropriate technology, processes, information and metrics, that means measurement of your data or information which is the according to metrics to achieve the business requirements. Third one is review and revision of a design. So reviewing all the process documents involved in service design, including design plans, architecture and different policies. So here we use this different revision or review of our design. So that means we have to update or upgrade of our services or to change our policies also. Next is production and maintenance. So here this production and maintenance in IT sector or IT policies and design documents, which includes designs, plans, architectures also. Now fifth one is development and implementation. So after that, the production and maintenance, we have to deployment and implement of your service. So that we have to create, make the planning for implementation of IT strategies using the different programs, different activities and project plans. So that we will get the exactly output or outcome of our service. Next is risk assessment and management. This is an important activity which in our design part. And last one is service design packages. So these are the basic design activities in our service design life cycle. Next is service design models. So there are five models, which first one is the targets, demands and requirements of new services. So in this model, we just create our different targets, users, customers, demands according to market and requirements of a new service which we have to update or upgrade our service. Now next is the scope and capability of the existing service provider unit. Suppose we already we gave the service, that time this existing service provide different targets or fulfill the targets or scope or capabilities we provide or not. But in new services, we have to create the something different or scope within the service in future. Next is the service drivers and its requirements. So how to maintain, how to drive our business in a proper manner. So this is again including in our design model. Fourth is the maturity of the organization currently involved and their processes. So organization has to currently involve each and every activity in our process or in their processes which they use different way. Now next is the scope and capabilities of external suppliers. That means if there is a different suppliers from external side, so we have to scope or their capabilities to maintain in our models. So these are the service design model. Now our next point is service design processes. This is a very important part which in we make the service perfectly or efficiently, because of we have to follow these processes. So first one is service catalog management. This is the first stage or first process in our service design, which is SCM. So a service catalog is a structured database or structured document with accurate information on all active services in service operation phase. So if your catalog is perfect or efficiently, we mention all the activities, all the information in proper manner, so it will be beneficial for our service system. So this is a very important phase in our service design. Next is service level management. In this SLM, there is a one important point which is a SLA, that is service level agreement. In this agreement, we have to return agreement between an IT service provider and a customer. So a SLA will typically define the warranty a service is to deliver and describe the utility of the service. So there is a clarity about the all the legal process and all the agreements should be in our SLA. So third one is capacity management. These are the seven processes in our service design. So third one is capacity management. In capacity management, we understanding the agreed current and future demands. So being made by customer for IT resources and producing forecasts for future requirements. So this is a for in future demands or requirements related to in future planning. Next is availability management. This process covers the design, implementation, measurement, management and improvement of IT services. So and there are the different components available, so you have to cover this this process in our availability management. Now fifth process, that is IT service continuity management. It is a very clearly we have to mention ki our design process should be continued, so that we have to follow some rules or some information related to service. That is the IT service continuity management. Major incidents and natural calamities may cause disruption to business activities and processes. So sometimes natural calamities are may be occur, so that we have to consider these things in our IT continuity management. Next is information security management. So security or there is a key process in our design, which is the customers and businesses expect that their information should be secure and the required level of confidentiality maintained. So this is a major purpose in our each and every service system. So this process should be in our maintain in our design. Now next last one is supplier management. This seven processes should be in compulsory in our design process. So supplier management, in this process to obtain the value for money from suppliers and contracts for the goods and services sourced and used for delivering services required by the business and the customers. So supplier management, again last process of our service design. So these are the all about of our service design, that is the second life cycle of service. Now we will discuss about the third life cycle in the next session. So thank you.